Hi guys. Okay, today we're going to do quite a short, easy, fun little project. We're going to make some little knitted flowers. You can use these on as decorations on bigger items. You can put them onto little brooch backs and use them as a little standalone piece. But they're just a nice, easy, fun project. Now, to do this project, you will need our usual knitting loom. You can actually use any size for this. I'm using my bigger size. But depending on the size of flower you make and just what loom you have without a current project on it, you can really use any size. They don't have to be the round ones either. You can use your rake looms for this as well. I also have some loom bands which I'm using as stitch markers. Obviously, you can use normal stitch markers if you like. Our big darning needle, some scissors, knitting hook. And just a pen and paper to keep track of rows. Also, obviously, you can use a row counter if you have one. And yarn, again, this is a good project for using up scrap yarn. I'm going to do like little six petal blossoms today. So I'm using some white and sort of pale pink patterned yarn there. And I've just got some of this sort of orangey yellow that I'm going to use as the centres. Okay. So as you will have heard there, I'm going to do six petals on this flower. I'm doing a little six petal blossom. You can change this, it's quite easy. You'll see how. The first thing we're going to do is mark up our loom. You don't have to do this once you get into the habit of making them, but to start off with, it's a lot easier. So the first thing I'm going to do is mark a starter peg. So there. That is my starter peg. And then I'm going to mark out for one petal. So one petal is one, two, three, four, and place a marker on it. Yeah. So there we go. So we have each set of four pegs is one petal, and then you need a marker peg in the middle. So I want six of these. So one, two, three, four. Place another one. One, two, three, four. Place another one. One, two, three, four. Place another one. Wait, how many petals am I up to here? I've got one. Got my starter, and I've got one, two, three, four. I just need another two. So one, two, three, four. Place another one. And one, two, three, four. And place another one. That's my last one. Now, if you've got a smaller loom, I know you're probably looking at this going, actually, Lily, this is quite a big loom project, you know. You can take these middle pegs down. You don't need to have four in there. You can take it down to three or to two. And in the other direction, you can take it up to five or six, depending how big you want them to be. I'm using four because I think it's just a nice number to kind of get us started with here. Okay. Okay, for this project, we're going to be knitting in the flat rather than in the round. So as I said, it makes no difference what sort of size and shape loom you use for this. You want to take the yarn that you're using for your petals rather than the centre of your flower first. And you're going to start by just making a small slip knot. I'm using DK weight yarn here, which I believe is the same as worsted weight over in the US. If not, I'm sure someone will correct us on that. But you can use any size you want for this project. Okay, so knitting in the flat with a basic A wrap. So we're just going to A wrap all the way around to the edge of the project. I'm a bit cross for focus. There we go. That's a bit better. We're going to go all the way around until we get to our last sort of little green marker. Which is this one? Yay. Okay. Now, as with all projects when you're knitting in the flat rather than in the round, on your very last peg, I'm just going to push these stitches down a bit to make it easier to work. There we go. Now, when you get to the end of a row, and it works the same on every row of these you do, when you get to the end, so this one, you just leave that there. You just ignore it. Just get left on the end, and then you go around again. Yeah. Now, you can wrap all of them, wrap right to the end, or if you're working on bigger looms like this, what I tend to do is wrap as I go. So just wrap and then knit them off. Oh, careful you don't catch your stitch markers. So this is going to be classed as my first row. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to keep knitting back and forward just with this plain A wrap until I've done four rows, okay? So I'm going to let you go and do that as well. Back and forward in the flat, and once you've done four rows, then come back and I'll catch up with you there. Okay, guys, I've now got my four rows of flat knit there. See it? Now what I need to do is I'm going to swap colours, but before I do that, I need to take care of the rest of my petals. So what I'm going to do, so I'm going to put, you can see there how long I've got on this. I'm going to take a good length tail on that working yarn. And then I'm going to get my darning needle. There's another darning video coming up as well soon, actually. If anyone watched the first one, it was a request. So I'm doing one. Now, what I'm going to do is include, I don't normally do the first one, but including the last one, I'm going to go through all of these like you were doing a cast off, but don't actually cast it off, but just go down through all of them. We go down through all of the stitches until you get to the other end. Try not to get your wool all snagged up like I do. Here we go. So yeah, you can see we're literally just coming down and through. And then moving on the next one, down and through. And like I said, just keep going till you get to the end. And I will see you when we're there. Okay? Okay, so I've now brought the wool back through all of the stitches, including the last one. I still have a good tail on it, but that's fine. So then we're just going to forget about that long tail of yarn for a while. We're going to leave it there. We're going to let it hang out. We will come back to it. And now I bet you're sitting there thinking, right, Lily, those green markers, what the heck were they for? Well, let me show you. Because now what we're going to do is we're going to go around and every single stitch that doesn't have a green marker on, just going to take it off. But all the green ones need to stay. Stay. Sneaky marker. Stay. Pop your finger on them when you're taking the others off. And there we are. So now we've just got the green markers left on. Now what I need to do is I need to move them all up to one end. Now you can do this with a crochet hook or a stitch keeper or whatever you want, but to be honest with you, I tend to just shuffle them. I find is actually the easiest way to do this. Just shuffle them over.
shuffle, shuffle. All the way round. There's only like seven of them. It doesn't take a huge amount of time. Plus, especially because you've got the what is normally sort of a cast off through thread that we've just done. It's, I just think shuffling them is a bit easier. I was saying before, I might do this again with five or six rows actually. With these little flower projects, they are so simple. And there's so many different ways you can do them. You can do a different number of petals. Like I say, you can do a different number of stitches per petal. There's no real perfect way to do them. It's just a case of playing about with them. And seeing what happens, seeing what you like. Are we almost there? We are almost there. Okay, so I've now got all of these stitches all shuffled up. One stitches. Now what you can do, you see this long tail we had? Just gonna making sure none of your stitches jump off because they're sneaky. I'm just gonna pull it. Just pull it. Keep pulling. Till you feel the resistance. And then stop pulling. Slacken it off a bit. Keep these neat. Okay. Cool. Awesome. Now we're going to take the colour that you're going to use for the centre of your flower. I'm just going to take that off there. Because I don't need to keep you on there anymore. I'm going to flick these two into the centre. Then I'm going to put a little slip knot on here. And I'm going to knit just over these seven stitches. I'm just going to straight knit three rows. Okay, that's all. Just three little rows, and you're taking both parts of these that are on here, because you will have a normal stitch and the, sorry, focus, there we go. You'll have the normal stitch and you will have the drawstringy part. So you take both bits and flick them over, yeah? There we go. So you want three rows with the yellow, or your whatever colour you're doing your centres. And once you are at that stage, come back. Okay, I've now done three rows on my yellow colour. I have cut a good tail length and put my darning needle onto it. And then what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go down through all of these again. Like I did the last time. Only this time there's only seven of them. Obviously if you're doing more petals, there will be more. Thing is, this time when I get to the end, what I'm going to do is, instead of just stopping, yarn. Instead of just stopping there, I'm going to come right the way back to this one and just put a final little one in there. Make sure I don't tighten a knot, yeah. Actually, flicking it behind is quite a good way of ensuring that. Then, once I've done that, all of these are going to come off as well, and you. And all of you. we do is we pull this really tight. As you can see, we has a pretty lacy flower. Now, what we're going to do here is we just need to stitch these up. Obviously, this is quite loose, so need my darning needle back. But all I'm going to do is flip this over. Make sure I don't get tangled, because you do end up with quite long tails on things. And pull that one up. And then I'm just going to stitch these through. And then I'm going to tie these two together. Okay, and then I'm going to do basically the same thing with these ones as well. So start with my long one that I pulled it in. Yeah. Start with this one. And again, just stitching down to the outside. Pop the little slip knot out. Tie these two together. I'm going to cut these two off because if you need to secure it to anything as a decoration, you're probably best off using the funky little yellowy orange ones in the centre. And there you go. Tiny cute flower. Knitted flower. Now, if you do this in thicker wool, you tend to get more defined petals rather than crinkly ones. Yeah, if you do, you know, longer ones, they can loop right up and round. There's a load you can do with them to make them slightly different, but that is how you knit funky little lacy flowers to go on your projects, basically. Yeah, so just have fun with them and see how you get on.